Good morning.
Today is Tuesday, May 14, 2019.
My name is Anna.
And I'm Seha.
Welcome to the Wildcat News Show.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. You may now have a seat.
Now here's Ms. Curry with the Gather Your Thoughts and Words of Wisdom.
Good morning, West Creek Wildcats. Welcome to this wonderful Tuesday. Today's supposed to be a little bit drier than yesterday, let's hope. We're going to start our day as we do every day, taking a moment to gather our thoughts. Now, I'm not going to prompt you with anything specific. We've learned a few strategies of visualization and self-talk and self-mindfulness, but I'd like you to take a moment. Think about today is Tuesday. We have still some learning to do and what we can do to have a great day on purpose. So let's take a moment right now and let's gather our thoughts. All right, thank you very much. And now I'd like to share with you a few words of wisdom. Asian Pacific Americans have made big contributions to our nation. They have made contributions by being teachers and writers, scientists, doctors, and much, much more. Confucius was China's most famous teacher and philosopher. His words of wisdom have lasted over 2,000 years, and he said this, "Words are the voice of the heart." Confucius is saying that your words show what's in your heart. From what you say and what you write, people can tell the respect and care you have for others and for yourself. Your words can make friends, they can hurt feelings, they can tell the truth or create lies, and they can also prove how smart you are. Your words are very powerful. So in honor of the traditions of Asian Pacific Americans, pay attention to the words you speak and write. What are your words showing about you? Now that's something to think about. And before I turn it back over to the news crew, we do have something special today because today is
Teacher Tuesday.
Teacher Tuesday. Today we only have one winner. So our one winner is going to get some fancy chocolate treats as well as a $10 Chick-fil-A car. So let's see who our lucky winner is. Anna, why don't you dig in there? Our bag is full. All right, and let's see. We have Miss Mira. Thank you for being a great team leader from Miss Trigo. Congratulations, Miss Mira. And now I'll turn it back over to the news crew.
We'd like to take a moment to recognize the top classes from each grade at level NAR. Drum roll, please.
Congratulations to Miss Mira's class in kindergarten, Miss Barman's class in first grade, and Ms. Rodriguez's class in second grade for being the top classes in their grade levels.
In third grade, we would like to congratulate Mr. Maramara's class in fourth grade. Congratulations to Mr. Featheroff's class. And in fifth grade, congratulations to Mr. Brock and Pascal's classes.
And now to recognize the names of the individual scholars with the highest number of error points from each grade level.
From kindergarten, congratulations to Malvin and Miss Mira's class. Malvin earned 65 points.
Wow.
Our first grade era superhero with 198 points is Ireland from Miss Brown's class.
Wow. 198.
From second grade, we would like to congratulate Sanskriti from Miss Howland's class. Sanskriti earned 180 points.
In third grade, a scholar from Mr. Mario Mara's class earned 450 points. Congratulations to Sarp.
Our fourth grade AR champion is also the highest number of points in the entire school. Please join us in recognizing Derek from Mr. Featheroff's class. Derek earned a total of 1,347 points.
And finally, we'd like to recognize our fifth grade scholar, earning 1,255 points. Congratulations to Gavin and Ms. Goldenberg's class.
Teachers and students, West Creek is collecting your used crayons, markers, highlighters, and dry erase markers.
Your used crayons will be recycled into new crayons and given to children in hospitals. And your used markers, highlighters, and dry erase markers will be recycled in an effort to reduce the impact on the environment.
We are collecting your used crayons, markers, highlighters, and dry erase markers the entire month of May.
Look for boxes in the lobby and on top of the stairs.
Thank you for joining us, and be sure to make it a great day,
or not, the choice is yours.